Hi guys, if at all you are the person who searches in the Google or in the YouTube that how can I improve my English by reading books, then this video is exactly for you. In this video, we will be understanding how can we improve the way we speak or understand English right from reading the books. Well, this video works both for readers as well as non-readers. So without further delay, let's dive into the video. Well, firstly, if at all you are speaking about improving our English, many YouTube videos and many Google articles always suggest that we need to be improving our vocabulary. Well, I need to emphasize this fact that if at all you are having a very good catch over vocabulary and you're able to use very sophisticated words in your conversation, but your grammar is quite a weak and you make many grammatical errors, then people will consider you that you do not understand or know English better. So, for improving your English right from the basics and covering all the aspects, you need to be improving grammar, pronunciation, as well as your vocabulary. I have divided this video into three sections. The first one is for the physical books, the second one is for the e-books, and the third one is for the audiobooks. I have added the respective timestamps in the description below so that you can jump to the exact section which suits you more. Other apparatus which you will be requiring is a kind of book or a notebook. I will be discussing with you how can you take the notes for improving your English at the end of the video. So make sure you're watching the video till the end. Moving on to the first section, that is physical books. Physical books or the hard copies can be really, really interesting and intriguing. For the people who are kind of interested already in reading, they always can be relating to the text, the way the plot proceeds. Well, the most easiest aspect in this is you can underline the important sentences and also the important vocabulary, the grammar which you have found in the book. Well, we'll be understanding it in a better manner. Let's proceed.
So hello guys, I have chosen The God of Small Things by Arundhati Roy as the book which I wanted to share with you all now. Well, firstly, I have chosen this sentence, for instance, from the page 250, and this line is what I feel for your reading in this manner. She concealed her anguish under the brisk, practical mask of a school teacher, the stern school teacher shaped whole in the universe, who sometimes slapped. But when Chaco wrote inviting her to IMNM, something inside her sighed and sat down. Despite everything that had happened between her and Chaco, there was nobody in the world she would rather spend Christmas with. So in this sentence, there are many words which you can be potentially underlining. The first one in the practical is the practical mask, and the word called stern, school teacher shaped hole. Coming to the sentences, you can be proceeding, but when Chaco wrote inviting her, this is past continuous tense, because wrote inviting is something in the past continuous tense, and something inside her sighed and sat down. Despite everything that had happened, again had is a past perfect tense, between her and Chaco, there was nobody in the world she would rather spend Christmas with. So in this paragraph itself, we have understood many aspects about the tense, about the many vocabulary, maybe like stern, there was sign, there was school teacher shaped hole, there is rote inviting, which resembles the tense. And in this page itself, you can come across many words such as equanimity. And there were many words, especially in this book, that is A God of Small Things by Arundhati Roy, which will absolutely help you to understand many instances about maybe tenses, or maybe about how you are understanding the plot, or about the words or the vocabulary. This book is kind of the best way you can proceed. I have already made a review of this book in my channel, so you can certainly check that video out.
Noting down things separately in a separate notebook is kind of quite interesting, and firstly, you will enjoy that process. But if at all you are not utilizing it in your daily language or your conversation, you always will be fading and you will be back to the square one. So it's better if at all you try to communicate with any other person standing before you. Now some people might ask me this question, that how can we communicate with people who themselves do not understand English, or kind of not interested, or they mock us because we speak broken English. It is quite an easy, if at all you want to overcome this issue, by writing a diary, or maybe a diary entry, a journal entry, or simply filling your slam book is kind of very easy. The most easiest process which I have found by researching a lot and myself is kind of reading the newspaper and trying to write the same article in your own words, and try to put down what you have understood from a specific article which the newspaper has to present. This is kind of the most easiest way, because no one is going to judge you, because you are just going to write. And after a couple of days, just get back to the text and check how have you improved in these couple of days. And obviously, you will be your own judge and you will be improving your English skills way better. Now we are jumping to the second section, that is ebooks. There are many sources such as Simply PDF, EPUB formats, or maybe Kindle, or many other platforms which provide you with free ebooks. So for the people who are kind of interested into reading books virtually or on computer screens, this section is kind of the most interesting one which you can ever find. Both PDFs or many an ebook format such as Kindle will provide you to actually highlight the lines which you are currently reading or underlining the lines which you love. And sometimes in some of the books, you have the opportunity of actually looking back and getting the list of all the highlighted things which you have done while you were reading the book. Now, as you have the electronic gadget right before you, it's quite an easy opportunity for you can be Googling things right and over there. When you have found a specific word, so as to improve your vocabulary, you can immediately go to the Google, find the exact meaning and maybe note down that meaning and try to use that word exactly on the same day many a time so that you can exactly register that word in your mind, improving your pronunciation. Because you already are reading something from the ebook, pronunciation is deeply impacted while you're Googling things. So when you go to Google, try to understand how the word is being pronounced, try to understand the syllables and how the phonetics go. So in that process, you can easily decipher how does this word is being pronounced and how do you understand that word. In this way, ebooks can be the most easiest way of achieving English. And as we all know, ebooks have the advantage over physical books of easily being carried anywhere or everywhere you love. And you can also pin your headphones, earphones, just listen to some soothing music and kind of improve the way you have been reading. Before going to the section 3, I would like to emphasize one more aspect, and that is if at all you are reading a physical copy or if at all you are reading an ebook, one thing which you have to understand is the grammar and the sentence formation. I give a lion's share of importance to reading in order to improve your way of speaking, may it be English, may it be your mother tongue or any other language which you try to read. The basic pillars to improve your language, one is reading and the other is speaking. If at all you are not having enough speakers to speak of, I have given you the suggestion of writing down things, which is kind of helpful. Well, if at all you are having speakers around you, then you are the most luckiest person. Well, moving on to the section 3, which is concerned with the audiobooks. With the advent of technology into our day-to-day lives, ebooks have converted themselves into audiobooks and we are absolutely loving them. Some people do not love reading, but they kind of are interested into listening. So this section is especially for the non-reader type of people who do not like opening the book and sitting in the corner of a bed trying to absorb the thing, but rather they do other chores and simultaneously listen to the book. So this section is mostly loved by the non-readers. And for the audiobooks, they have an edge of understanding the pronunciation and the sentence formation very easily. I understand it is a little difficult while you're listening to audiobook and rather noting down the things in your notebook, but it is the only method which you can improve your vocabulary. YouTube is the kind of best platform you can ever find for the audiobooks, but if at all you have any other apps such as Storytel or Audible with you and you have a subscription for them, then you are the luckiest person ever. You can just go to YouTube, search the exact book which you want in the audiobook format, and there are about 75% of chances you will be finding that audiobook absolutely for free. Then one master stroke which I would love to share in here is listening to audiobook plus combining it with an ebook or a physical book. You will be holding the physical book and the ebook in your hands, but you'll be listening to the audiobook simultaneously. This exactly works the way in our schools, where in a class, our teacher used to make exactly a specific student stand and read an exact paragraph. We, while listening to that paragraph, used to also read the text from our own textbooks. In this manner, because we are introducing two senses, that is both auditory senses as well as the visual senses into understanding, our brain easily merges both of them to come up with a new thing, and that kind of new thing will be making you to understand the plot as well as increase your vocabulary, fluency, grammar. If at all you find any mistakes in the grammatical or the sentence formation in the book, you can easily find them out. Now coming on to the fourth section of the video, that is the most important one, how are we taking the notes, which I have said both for the physical books, ebooks as well as the audiobooks. As we have already seen from the page number 250 that we have underlined some specific lines. Now we are going to note them down into pretty easy manner so that we can be understanding things. So we have got three words, that is turn, side and equanimity in this. Now we need to be Googling the things and getting the meaning of them, out of which the meaning of side is kind of emit a long deep audible breath or because of sadness, and you need to be writing the exact sentence which you need to be thinking about. If at all you're using the word equanimity, which means patience or composure, kind of again can be used in a sentence here. Then if at all using the word stern, it's
and you can use a sentence. And these sentences are the one which you need to be using day to day in your own life. And this will be giving you a clear picture of idea how should you be improving your vocabulary even while reading the books.
So that's all, guys. These were the very few tips which I think I would have given in this video. Speaking English, improving your fluency or improving your vocabulary doesn't occur just in one day or an overnight scenario. It takes eons for you to actually do that. But there, in this race of understanding the language, there is no superior or inferior. There is just a difference in understanding the language. Please don't get demotivated that you do not understand English. In understanding or reading English is not the criteria for you to be judged in this world. We'll be meeting you in the next video. Till then, stay safe, take care, bye-bye.